Hey guys, welcome to the channel. In this video, we will see how we can download and install C and C++ compiler or the toolset in Windows 11 operating system very easily. So what you have to do is you have to open up any browser that is installed in your computer. I have Microsoft Edge. I'm going to open it up. And here in the URL bar, we will enter the website address as winlibs.com and we will open up the website. So here we can see that we will get the standalone build for GCC and MinGW. Now here you can read through all these things and understand more about this. What we do is we will go down to the download section and here we can find the release versions. So we will download under this UCRT runtime and we will download whatever the latest version that is available and we will download it with the POSIX threads. Okay, so here now we can see that we have the option to download for Windows 32-bit operating system and Windows 64-bit operating system. So depending on the operating system that is installed in your computer, you can choose a download option in here. Now here I will go with the Windows 64-bit and zip archive and I will click on this. And once I click on that, the download will begin. We have to wait for this download to finish. Okay, now the download is complete. If I take the cursor on this downloaded file, then I can see this folder icon. If I click on that, it will open up the folder where the downloaded files are saved, generally in the downloads folder. And here we can see that this is a zip file that is downloaded. So what we do is we will right click here on this file and we will click on extract all. And we have to select the location where we want to install it. So here we will click on this browse and then I will go to this PC and here local disk C drive and here I will extract these files. So I will select this C drive and I will click on this select folder just like this and we will check this option which says show extracted files when complete. And then we will click on this extract. Now it will start extracting the files. Again, we have to wait for this to complete. Okay, now the extraction is complete. And once the extraction is complete, it will open up the folder where all these files are extracted. If you remember, we have extracted the files in the C drive. So in this C drive, we can see a folder created with the name MinGW64 and this is a folder which contains all the extracted files. So now what we have done is we have downloaded MinGW and we have saved those files in the computer. But in order to access them from any folder in the file system, we have to update the path environment variable with the location of the C and C++ compilers. And these programs are present inside this MinGW64 folder. So what we do is we will open up the folder where all the extracted files are present. In this case, this C drive and this MinGW64 folder. We will open it up. We can see this bin folder in here. We will open this up. And now here we can see all these programs present. For example, you can see that we have GCC, which is a C compiler, G++, which is a C++ compiler, all these programs and GDB, which is a debugger, all these programs are present here. So what we have to do is we have to copy the path of this particular location. One simple trick that we can do is if we take the cursor on this top navigation section, and if we left click here, it will highlight the path like this. C, MinGW64, bin folder. We will right click and copy this path. Once we copy this path, we can minimize this explorer window. And then we will click on the start button and we will search for edit environment variables for your account. So we will click on this option. It will open up this edit environment variables section. And here in this user variables section, we can find path. We will select by clicking on that and then we will click on edit and here we will click on new and then we will paste the path that we have copied just like that and then we will click on OK, and then we will click on OK. So now, in order to check everything is properly installed, we will click on the start button, search for CMD, and we will open up the command prompt. And here we will check the version of GCC installed. To do that, we will type in GCC space minus minus version. And now you can see the version of GCC that is installed in this computer. Similarly, we can check G++ space minus minus version of G++ that is installed. And again, we can check the version of GDB, that is the debugger. So it will be GDB space minus minus version. And here we can see the version of GDB. So this is how we can download and install the C and C++ compiler or the toolset very easily in Windows operating system. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, hit the dislike button. If you have anything to say, write that in the comment box. For more tutorials like this, subscribe to the channel.